John has asked, what applications would you use soldering with rather than a crimp? Okay, so solder, while obviously during the lesson, I did mention that we want to use it as little as possible, and I gave you all of the reasons why that's the case. There is still the reality that, yes, there are some applications where solder is absolutely the correct choice. So the first of these would be some of the specific connectors where they use solder pots on the back of, or solder cups, I should say, on the back of the connector. Think of the D9 serial connector. That's generally how those will work. They'll have a little solder cup. You solder your wires into those solder cups. The other option would be the XLR connector, same deal there. Now, with both of these, the key is mitigating the downsides of solder. So typically, what we need to do is make sure that vibration is eliminated and we've got as much strain relief as possible. So this is where we pot, where possible, the back of the connector to make sure that the wires are supported and aren't going to move. Now, another common use for solder, and right up to the likes of F1, a professional motorsport, is where the back of a sensor or actuator is potted. And what we do here is we eliminate the existing connector that would go to that sensor or actuator. Often these end up being unreliable in professional motorsport levels. And what we do is we cut down the connector body so we've got access to the terminals inside the connector. And we'll then solder our wire directly onto the sensor or actuator. Now again, this provides this problem where the solder will work up our wire. So once they're soldered on, they're then going to be potted. So we'll fill the back of that connector with the epoxy, and that provides the mechanical strain relief and support. And then to go one step further, once that epoxy has set up and cured overnight, we'll then apply a heat molded boot to the back of that particular sensor or connector. And these heat molded boots, once they recover, are pretty semi-rigid, pretty rigid. So again, just providing further strain relief. That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.